Viewers, a senior UN official says he is concerned about grave and distressing allegations of human rights abuses in Ethiopia's Tigray region, including killing, targeted abductions, and the forced return of refugees to Eritrea. These are concerted indications of major violations of international law. The UN High Commissioner of Refugees, Filippo Grandi, added in a statement. He said the UN Refugees Agency had not been given access to the Shimbila and its test refugees campus in Tigray since early November, when Ethiopia's Prime Minister and Nobel Peace Laureate Abiy Ahmed ordered a military operation to oust the Tigray People's Liberation Front, TPLF, from power in the region after the party's troops captured federal military bases. There have been present reports that Eritrean forces have been fighting in Tigray to help Ethiopian troops defeat the TPLF. Eritrean troops have also been accused for forcibly taking back Eritrean refugees who lived in the UN-run campus in Tigray. Both the Ethiopian and Eritrean governments deny that Eritrean troops are in Tigray. But Mr. Grandi said, reports of additional military incursions over the last 10 days are consistent with open source satellite imagery showing new forest burning and other fresh signs of destruction at the two campuses. Nearly 1 lakh Eritreans lived in four campuses in Tigray after feeling political persecution and military conscription in the one-party state. Mr. Gandhi welcomed access being granted to Mai Aini and Adi Harush campus, but said he very worried for the safety and well-being for Eritrean refugees at the Shimbila and his test campus. So this is the news. Please subscribe channel and don't forget to press bell icon for latest news. Thanks for watching.